Okay, so good afternoon. Hello, guys. So today our topic is about phylum Sarcomastigophora, specifically ang mga Sarcodina. Ayan. So first part, Sarcodina muna tayo. In this video, Sarcodina muna tayo. So your Sarcodina both has your pathogenic and your non-pathogenic amoeba. So ang mga amoeba guys, their locomotion so that they could move around, they have pseudopods. Yan. So under Sarcomastigophora, ang mga Sarcodina class, they are amoeba and they have pseudopods as their way of moving around. For the next video guys, is Mastigophora, or the way of their moving around is their flagella, or they are also called your flagellates. So guys, for this video, mag-focus tayo sa mga Sarcodina. Yan. So guys, ayun nga, may pathogenic at non-pathogenic pa. Amoeba, sa madaling salita, usually, ang pinakasikat lang na pathogenic amoeba is your Entamoeba histolytica. However, guys, however, plus we have other pathogenic amoeba which are free-living or opportunistic amoeba, meaning unless you are immunocompromised, that's the only time that you will get infected with these diseases. So, based on this table, we base them on their habitat. So we have intestinal species. So we have Entamoeba histolytica, Hartmannii, Entamoeba coli, Endolaia muscnina, Iodamoeba, at itong mga Entamoeba, Mushkovsky, Poleki, Shaten. Guys, please read Belisario for these ones. And so, usually they're found in animals, ganun. And class, we have extra-intestinal species. So, they infect, or their habitat is outside the intestine. So we have Entamoeba gingivalis. So ang bahay na class, it's around the oral area, gum area. We have Naegleria fowleri and Acanthamoeba. So these are free-living amoeba. Free-living amoeba. And guys, itong Naegleria tsaka Entamoeba, ito yung mga sinasabi kong opportunistic amoeba. Or yun, free-living. So opportunistic, they only could infect a person unless they're immunocompromised. So the key characteristic of your amoeba is they have pseudopods. So they extend their cytoplasm. So they have false feet. Ayan. So, ayun. So we have, so madali lang yung life cycle ng amoeba natin. We only have trophozoite and cysts. So your gingivalis, guys, do not have any cyst form. In class, your Dientamoeba fragilis was back then an amoeba, but now it's part of your intestinal flagellate, so Mastigophora siya. So most of them inhabit your large intestine. We have yon, except Entamoeba gingivalis. Yung Naegleria tsaka Acanthamoeba, their habitat is in the central nervous system, and most of the time they are free living. So they could live outside of the body. So almost all are commensals. So meaning they're really not parasitic in nature, except your Entamoeba histolytica. We have these terms, guys, existation and encystation. So for existation, so cyst is converted to trophozoite. So when the environment is good, specifically when the cyst of a amoeba is in the ileocecal area of the intestine, there is existation. So it turns from cyst to trophozoite. So yun yung sinasabi ko sa discussion natin, that there's no form, walang aging, there's no concept of aging in your Sarcodina. So it turns into cysts if the environment is not crucial or it's harmful. Example, there is amoeba overpopulation, pH change, oxygen change, change in food supply. So trophozoites turns into cysts, and we call it encystation. So if the parasite would want to go to a survival mode, kung gusto niyang mag-survive sa harmful environment, there is encystation. The trophozoite becomes cyst. So usually, pag kunyari, palabas na sa digestive, pag nag-number 2 na yung pasyente, so end stage na yun. Kasi harmful na yung environment sa labas ng intestine. Yan. But if usually, pag yung pag okay yung environment, yun, nagiging trophozoite. Is it kasi that the trophozoite is the sexual stage, the feeding stage? Sabi ng mga entamoeba, so they are the true amoeba. So they have peripheral chromatin, they have nuclear membrane, they have chromatoidal bodies. So, yun, chromatoidal bodies are usually present in young cysts also. Endolymax and iodamoeba, no peripheral chromatin and chromatoidal bodies. So, chromatoidal bars or bodies, so they are condensed RNA material. So, isn't it, pag narinig nyo na class yung chromatoid, chromatin, class, these are genetic materials. So, karyosome or karyosomal chromatin. So, class, your karyosome is usually on the center or in the middle of your nucleus. So, yan, central mass of chromatin. So, it's a condensed genetic material. We also have peripheral chromatin. So, this surrounds your karyosome. And we have glycogen mass as the storage of food and nutrients. Yan. So, class, the usual laboratory diagnosis of the routine. So, sa line with preparation. So, you can see the motility, the movement of your trophozoite. We have iodine wet preparation. Guys, this kills your trophozoite. So, however, we could see the inclusions in your cytoplasm of your cyst and nuclear structures of your cysts. Permanent smear, class, ito daw yung the best to really identify your protozoa because you could really distinguish their identifying characteristics. Yeah. So guys, these are the differences between your trophozoite and your cyst. Sabi niya, trophozoites are motile and it's delicate and fragile. So therefore, within 30 minutes is dapat kung watery yung cyst, ay watery yung stool, and you want to check for trophozoite, dapat within 30 minutes na sa laboratory na yung stool. And class, trophozoites are never the infective stage because it could be destroyed by drying and gastric juices of your stomach. Yeah. So it's replication. How do protozoa reproduce? Sabi niya, asexual binary fission. So yung trophozoite nag-separate into two. Yan. Sabi ng teacher ko noon, boring daw. Buti na lang daw, hindi siya trophozoite. So your trophozoite is the feeding stage. So usually, it's only found in watery stools. Pag loose yung consistency, sa form, walang trophozoite, guys. And it's destroyed by iodine. So cyst, it's non-motile. Kumbaga, pag nasa cyst stage, it's in the survival state. So because the cyst has a protective cell wall against the harmful environment. Example, kunyari, there's overpopulation of amoeba. Sobrang rami na, nag-aagawan na sila ng food supply. And cyst stage, ang galing, no? And so on. So good na mag-study ng cyst sa iodine mount sa permanent stain. So your trophozoites, class, of your entamoeba histolytica. So ang key characteristic ng trophozoite ng histolytica is it ingests your red blood cells. Kung red blood cells sa histolytica, sa entamoeba coli, class, bacteria, yeast, cell detritus or cell debris. Yeah. Sabi niya, dirty-looking trophozoite. Dapat, dirty-looking trophozoite ang entamoeba coli. Ang entamoeba histolytica, clean-looking trophozoite. Ayan. So, yan, class. Ayan, pakibasa yung mga difference nila. So, dito daw sa trophozoite, finger-like projection yung pseudopod niya. Itong kay entamoeba coli, blunt and round yung trophozoite niya. So, finger-like. So, may pagkapatulis yung pseudopod niya. So, yung sa entamoeba coli, blunt. So, your histolytica is unidirectional. It goes to one direction. May pinupuntahan. Entamoeba coli, it's sluggish. Hindi niya alam po saan siya pupunta. It does not really move around. Yan. For the cyst ng entamoeba histolytica, so, meron tayong chromatoidal body or na coffee shape, sausage shape, or round of rounded, and dito sa chromatoidal bar ng E. coli class, splinter or broom or whisk. Yun, maninipis. And class sa cyst ng histolytica 4, quadrinucleated. Quadrinucleated siya. Dito sa Entamoeba coli, up to eight nuclei. So your coli class is non-pathogenic, it's commensal. So laboratory diagnosis ng histolytica, so wet preparation, permanent staining. So mas sensitive syempre ang concentration techniques, ang culture. Yun. Eliza sabi ni Belisario, differentiation between E. histolytica and E. dispar is not possible by microscopy. So if you will see a E. histolytica looking trophozoite or cyst in the stool, so ang report natin E. histolytica or E. dispar cyst and trophozoite. Kasi they're indistinguishable unless you will use PCR, ELISA, isoenzyme analysis. Ayun, so yung clinical significance ng amoeba class, so amoebiasis, intestinal amoebiasis, so once your Entamoeba histolytica is now multiplying in the intestine, tapos magiging amoebic colitis, so infection of the intestine, hanggang palala, amoebic dysentery, so the stool now has blood and mucus, extra-intestinal amoebiasis, ito na yung mas malala because it went out of the intestine, which caused liver abscess, amoebic pneumonitis sa lungs. It can infect the pericardium, the spleen, the skin, the brain. And class, ayun, pwede rin siyang maging sexually transmitted disease. So, venereal amoebiasis, penile amoebiasis, vaginal amoebiasis. Mas lalo na, yun, pag kunyari, may anal sex, something like that. So, yun, the difference between amoebic dysentery and bacillary dysentery. So, maybe epidemic. So, mas madaling kumalat class ang bacillary dysentery tsaka kumpara sa amoebic dysentery. Acute onset, mabilis sa bacillary, mabagal sa amoebic. Prodromal fever and malay common, no prodromal fever. And guys, please Google, what does prodromal mean? Vomiting, more on bacillary. So, plus mahalaga rin to, no? Kasi if you were feeling LBM, tapos may suka. So, kung magiging dysentery man yun, mostly bacillary yun. So, bloody diarrhea, odorless sa bacillary dysentery, amoebic, mas mabaho. Yeah, that's true. Mas mabaho sa amoebic. Stool microscopy, numerous bacilli and pus cells. Pag bacillary, pag amoebic dysentery, hindi pa mo ng pus cells. Macrophages, red cells, no charcot-laden crystals. Stool microscopy, few bacilli red cells. Trophozoite with ingested red cell and charcot-laden crystals. Mas matindi ang crumbs sa bacillary, tenesmus common. So, ayan yung paghihilab ng chan, ng tenesmus. So, even though you already pooped, however, humihilab pa rin na parang meron pa rin pero wala namang lalabas. Natural history spontaneous in recovery. For amoebic dysentery, it could last for weeks. However, it could persist for years. So class, meron rin tayong ito. Ito yung mga commensal natin. So class, lahat mahalaga. So ang tawag sa Entamoeba hartmanni, small rays, E. histolytica. So mas maliit na E. histolytica. And the Limax ning na smallest amoeba, RBC in size. So isn't it that the size of your RBC is about 6 to 8 micrometers? So, yun. Sabi niya, cross-eyed cysts. Blot-like yung karyosome nila. Iodamoeba butchlii. Pag double eye daw eh. Lii, ganyan. So, ayun, may achromatic granules. So, intracellular and motility are same with Entamoeba coli. So, ibig sabihin, blunt I mean, may bacteria sa loob. It moves sluggishly. It only has one nucleus. Ito class, may glycogen vacuole siya, which is very prominent in under Lugol stain. We have Entamoeba gingivalis, homodont of transmission, kissing, doublet, spray, sharing utensils. Extrudes to the body, similar to E. hystericula, but does not exhibit true progressive motion. So, commensal itong mga to, ha? And so, guys, dito tayo sa opportunistic amoeba. Na-OC ako, ano ba yan? So, yun, it's a your opportunistic amoeba, so meaning it could only cause disease, especially those who are immunocompromised, mga old people, pregnant women, mga neonates. Ito, free-living amoeba that inhibits your central nervous system. So, class, kung may mga na example, makakita kayo ng Entamoeba coli, ganyan, maka-identify kayo sa isang ihe. So, ibig sabihin, there could be fecal contamination. But if you're seeing Naegleria fowleri, Acanthamoeba on your urine specimen, so it's not possible. Ah. So, this species does not show a fecal contamination. Kasi, ang bahay nila, free-living sila. Tsaka, central nervous system ang gusto nila. Okay? So, class, yung Naegleria fowleri, interesting to. Kasi, dalawa yung ano niya eh. Pero dalawa yung form niya. Pwede siyang amoeboid, trophozoid form, amoeboid, left, and flagellate form. So yung pang swimming niya, amoeba flagellate. Pero may stage rin siya. So your Naegleria fowleri class, wag kakalimutan, lumalabas sa board exam, it causes primary amoebic meningoencephalitis. So central nervous system talaga sila. Namamalagi, at it could enter into your body through intranasal mucosa. So, sa ilong, class, if you are swimming in hot weather in brackish or fresh water and swimming pool. Ayun. So, yan. Ang specimen niya, CSF, brain tissue, causes purulent spinal fluid. And finally, class, Acanthamoeba. So, class, ito ang weird ng trophozoite niya. So, may thorn-like appendages. It also has cyst form. It could cause keratitis sa mata. And granulomatous amoebic encephalitis. One way to diagnose it is using BAP flooded with 24 hours. Escherichia coli. Yeah. So, ngayon, guys. So, free-living natin, Acanthamoeba, Naegleria free-living pero matindi sa central nervous system sila. PAM sa Naegleria fowleri, GAE, tsaka keratitis sa Acanthamoeba. So guys, that's all for today. I'll see you again. And bye-bye!